Hey, Canucks fans, along with giving credit to the players, we also must give credit to head coach Travis Green. I'm Clay Emo. I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter. I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCBC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club. This is my Canucks take, all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Thursday, August the 20th. This is where you get Canucks insight that's positive and timely. Thanks to everyone who joined me for my live stream last night. Had our biggest audience ever at about 150, 160 people at our peak, over 1,500 views natively right away. So we had a good time, spoke for about 65 minutes after the game. And it's always a good time after a Canucks win. Tomorrow's gonna be more challenging as I'm emceeing an event that starts at basically 5:30, goes to 11. So I'm not sure, I'm probably gonna schedule my live stream for 11:30 or so. So anyone who's up late, you're welcome to join me. And of course, I think if the Canucks win tomorrow and eliminate the Blues, there's going to be a lot more people than, say, if the Canucks lose. But I mean, we'll see. We'll see. We'll worry about that tomorrow. Today, let's talk about last night. I already talked in my post-game, my quick two-minute video, as well as the live stream. Obviously, Jacob Markstrom and Tyler Motte, two of the standouts. Markstrom, so many good saves, especially in that second period, keeping the team in when they looked like they were down and out. And Tyler Motte, two beautiful goals, a shorthanded quasi-breakaway, and then a true breakaway that was the game-winning goal at the end of the second period. Also, two-point nights for Pettersson, Miller, and Jake Virtanen. And that's really, when you look at, well, you say, that's kind of weird, Clay. Why were those three guys playing together? That's what I want to talk about today. Travis Green coached a heck of a game last night. And I think it's fair to say that many people thought that Green was getting out-coached in the series, especially in Games 3 and Game 4, when the Canucks seemingly had no answer for Ryan O'Reilly, David Perron, and Jaden Schwartz. Now, the Canucks held that line in check yesterday, both from a personnel standpoint and from a strategy standpoint. You know, you can only do so much, and O'Reilly still scored that goal, that kind of fluky second goal, the St. Louis goal on the wraparound. But you could tell that they had to work harder last night. They weren't getting as many quality looks. They weren't left alone in the slot as much. And then they were making it harder on those three guys to play in their own end. All things that the Canucks said they had to do after their Game 4 loss. But let's talk more about the personnel and the way Travis Green coached yesterday. It was really fascinating because in the warm-up, he had 19 skaters, not the typical 18. So there's already some intrigue there because Adam Gaudette was not in line rushes, but he was still out there for the warm-up. And then sure enough, when the game started, Zach McKeown was out and Adam Gaudette was in. And by the way, Gaudette was fine. You know, he you could tell he was trying hard. He wanted to make an impact, bring some energy. Didn't hurt the team, but didn't play much in the third period. And that's something Travis Green likes to do, right? When the third period comes, whether we're trying to get a goal or trying to protect a one-goal lead like we were yesterday, he basically shortens his bench from four lines to three. So he'll keep the top two lines. And then of the bottom six, he will take his best three players and make them play. And last night, the bottom six that did play, if you consider that Virtanen was the top six by then, was basically Louis, Tyler Motte, and Jay Beagle. So that means Anton Roussel barely saw the ice in the third. Brandon Sutter barely saw the ice in the third. And then Adam Gaudette barely saw the ice in the third. So like I said, the top six and then the third line, the combined third line was Beagle with Motte and with Louis Eriksson. A pretty good shutdown line when you think about things. But let's talk about the top six, and that's where the brilliance of Travis Green's coaching showed up yesterday. So not only did he insert Gaudette in the lineup for McKeown after the warm-up, but he started actually the game with Horvat between Miller and Besser. So basically he removed Petey and he put Horvat up there. That's obviously a bigger line with Horvat in there instead of Pettersson. But then it didn't leave Pettersson with much when you think about it. That left Pettersson, at least to start the game, with Pearson and Eriksson. Remember, Virtanen had started the game on the fourth line. So you have Pettersson with Pearson and Eriksson, and I kind of tweeted out that I was afraid that would be taxing on Pettersson, and he might feel like he have to do everything on his own. And we saw that a few rushes in the first period where he didn't pass to Louis or didn't pass to Pearson. I wouldn't either if I was good as Petey. And you saw Pettersson try to make at least two, or if not three, try and rushes through the middle of the ice on his own without passing. And then the Canucks come out of, and then the Besser Horvat Miller line was fine. And then you come out of that first period down 2-1 though. Then St. Louis scores on the power play 6 minutes in the second, and it looks pretty grim, 3-1. And then Travis Green made a switch that obviously paid off, and I guess he liked the way Jake was skating, or he wanted more speed, so he actually reunited Pettersson with Miller, and then he put Jake Virtanen there instead of Besser. So now it was a first line of Pettersson, Miller, and Virtanen, and then the second line had Besser come down to that. So now it was Horvat, Besser with Pearson, and then Louis gets dropped to either third or fourth line. But Louis ends up playing still because he's good defensively. So that's an interesting top six now, because with Jake Virtanen on the top line instead of Besser, you automatically are a lot faster. You could argue that Virtanen's got a good release on his shot as well, and was playing some confidence last night. So that was the one thing you noticed about Virtanen was his speed and how much it actually opens up space for Miller and Pedersen. And on the second goal, Virtanen made a nice little pass to Miller behind the net. Miller jams it in. On the third goal, a nice three-way cycle game on using one quarter of the ice between Pedersen, Miller, and Virtanen leads to Virtanen's short side goal on Jake Allen. Then on your second line, that line becomes a bit heavier now. So instead of Horvat, Pearson, Eriksson, you have Horvat, Pearson, and Besser. It gets a bit it's still a heavy line. It's not the fastest line because Horvat's the fastest skater of those three. But at least there's more scoring potential there. And they didn't figure on the score sheet yesterday. But I have no problem with Brock playing with Bo, actually, because they've shown some chemistry a couple years ago playing together. And that's what your top six ended up looking like. And it paid dividends because that top line of Miller, Pedersen, and Virtanen all had 2 points apiece. You know, Miller and Virtanen a goal and assist, and Petey with two assists on those very important second and third goals for the team. Basically, the two goals that weren't Tyler Mott. So overall, I thought it was really, really good coaching by Travis Green. And remember, this was in a game where they were the away team, so technically they couldn't match lines in theory, although of course you can do so during the flow of the game. And remember, the Canucks are 5-0 when they're the away team, and they're only 1-3 when they're the home team. So unfortunately, Game 6 is a home game, but maybe with last change, with newfound confidence in the lines, a new look, maybe we will get another home win and close out the series, which would be awesome. I guess the other tricky wrinkle in there is if Tyler Toffoli comes back to play, and if he's healthy to play for Game 6, which some people are hoping that he is, then what do you do? Well, in that case, I think you got to get Toffoli in your top six. So do you put him up with the Lotta line and then try Besser, Horvat, Pearson, and then have Virtanen start on a third or fourth line and then work his way up? Maybe that's fine, because I don't think anyone's thinking that Virtanen's going to be a mainstay on that top line. Or do you actually keep Virtanen with Miller and Pedersen, try Toffoli on the second line with Pearson and Horvat, and then drop Brock down to a third line? That doesn't sound right to me, but maybe it balances the potential for scoring out a little more. Who knows? But let's worry about that tomorrow if it happens. And one other thing, it sounds like Rick Dhaliwal just reported on Sports TSN 1040, that what he's hearing from Edmonton is that Edler will be okay and that he should be good to go for Game 6, which would be a huge, huge bonus. You know, took that scary skate to the ear and probably needed a lot of stitches, wasn't able to play in the third period. So kudos to the five remaining defensemen for spreading out their minutes, especially Quinn Hughes, and protecting that one goal lead, not even letting a goal in that third period. But obviously, if Alex Edler is able to play tomorrow, that's huge, especially already given the absence of Tyler Myers. So some things to think about, but Canucks fans, for today, really, I guess the question of the day is obviously we know that the line switching went well, but do you think Jake Virtanen has a potential to stick with Miller and Petey? Or would you, whether or not Toffoli comes back, would you go back to a more traditional lineup and then let Jake Virtanen kind of work his way up during in-game, depending on how well he's going? Or would you, Toffoli or not, would you flat out start Virtanen on that top line on Friday night when the Canucks have last change? So that's my question of the day for you. Let me know what you think about that, just about Virtanen's play, and where do you think he should play next game? Or do you think he could play on the third or fourth line and bring some scoring touch and confidence to them? Or maybe he needs really skilled players to score goals. Let me know what you think about Virtanen's play. Let me know what you thought about the game overall tonight, last night. And then I'd love to read, react, and reply as always. Subscribe if you like to. Like this video if you like to. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care of yourselves, and take care of each other. Have a great day. God bless, and go Canucks, go.